Hi, I'm Brittany Umar, and welcome to The Nooner. And despite Rex Ryan's claims, we are the biggest show in town. Yesterday was garbage bag day for the Jets, usually observed on October 1st in Queens. Gang Green packed up their lockers in Forest Green and looked forward to next season. Rex Ryan wants Darrelle Revis to get even better by leading the defense. Translation, Lito Shepard sucks, and next year Revis will have to cover two receivers per game. Regarding Kerry Rhodes, Ryan would only say, there's an individual thing that Kerry and I have talked about. I'd rather just keep it individual. Translation, you are not too sexy for the catwalk. For the catwalk, yeah. Put your little shirt on and play some football, yeah. Rex also claimed that this isn't the same old Jets. Like I said, punch somebody in the nose for it if that's the case. Braylon Edwards' translation, ask LeBron's buddy, I'm one step ahead of you. Damian Woody said he was impressed with Mark Sanchez's growth, stating, right now, after Sunday, he might be potty trained. My translation, gross. Kinda hot? No, just gross. Over to baseball, the Mets kicked off a mini camp in Port St. Lucie yesterday, and we think every player made it through the workout without having surgery. Reports say that the Amazons roster isn't set yet. Apparently, pitchers Ben Sheets and John Garland are on the team's radar, and team officials are carefully watching them swiftly move away from the center of the radar and then off the screen entirely as they work quickly to sign with any other team beside the Mets. Bobby Parnell, Daniel Murphy, and Eddie Koons were also in camp, as was Jack Egbert. Yeah, that's apparently a real guy. He's a local product from Rutherford, New Jersey, and he signed with the Mets for bail money after the Colts game. Hey, Ollie was in the house too. We've met many versions of Ollie. Good Ollie, bad Ollie, fat Ollie, weird beard Ollie, overpaid Ollie. But this is Arizona Ollie, in shape and ready to go. But like his fastball, we're just not sure where he's going. Over to funnier news, shocking developments in the Tiger Woods story. Apparently, Elin found out about Tiger's affair with Rachel Yucatel and chased him out of the house with a golf club, prompting his crash into the fire hydrant. Wow, just another stunning exclusive from the people who brought you, Mark McGwire took steroids. According to the Daily Beast, Tiger's wife allegedly caught him cheating by texting Yucatel, pretending she was Tiger. She then called the party girl from his phone, and when Yucatel answered, the angry wife reportedly said, I knew it was you. Oh, a stunned Yucatel reportedly replied and hung up. Caller ID giveth, and caller ID plus prenuptial agreements taketh away. But you must admire Mrs. Wood's technological trickery. Maybe Omar should try calling free agents with Brian Cashman's phone. Okay, I'm done for the day. Where's my garbage bag?